Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and this is the start of my next lathe project. But we're not going to do this project on the wood lathe. We're going to do this on the metal lathe. What we have here in front of us is a piece of 2-inch steel stock that used to be a pin that held up a big ram in the back of a dump truck to lift up the bed to dump it. Several years ago, I worked on the dump truck. It had tipped over, and it had bent this pin. So I had a lot of work to do on that dump truck, but I have the pin. And so what I need to do in order to ready this for our project is I need to, since it is bent, I'm going to find out where the actual bend is, and I'm going to cut this puppy off in my bandsaw so that we get a nice stock of steel, and then depending on where it gets cut, I may or may not cut the holes out of the other end. But that's where we're going to start. I cleaned some rust off of it on the brake lathe after I cut it off to the length I want, and I've got a pretty nice profile there for an old Cannon. We'll see where we can go from here. I'm going to take it to the belt sander and do some polishing on it. There, the belt sander did a real nice job on it. I'm not going to worry about this area in here because it's going to get painted black when I'm done anyway. And I really kind of want it to look like it was cast, so a little rougher will look a little better. Got the ends rounded off nicely, and we're on to the next step. No self-respecting cannon would be complete without a muzzle hole. So I bored a muzzle hole. I bored one about 2 inches into the back, so it looks like it's real. Or into the front, I'm sorry. And then in the back, I bored a 1/8-inch diameter hole a little ways into it so that we can stick a fake fuse in the back and make it appear as though it's a real cannon. Okay, now that we've got the bore drilled back in to look as though it's real and a hole in the back to look like it could use a fuse, we need some way to attach this to its carriage. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to weld some rod out the side here. This is about 5/8 or 9/16 rod, and then I'll attach it to the carriage in such a way that it can aim up and down to appear as though it has an elevation adjustment. Now we have our supports welded on. We need to clean up these welds and make some brackets to hold them on to the support. I laid down a bunch of extra rod here so that I can transition this weld and make it appear as though the support brackets here were actually cast onto the cannon barrel, which we know they were not, but you know, when we're dealing with decorative stuff, I don't mind blowing a little extra rod for appearance sake. Normally on something this light, I wouldn't care, but I think it'll look better. Now let's grind her up and we'll find out. Now that it's cooled off, we'll stick a couple of wheels on the axles here. We're going to have to shorten these axles up a little bit. They're still too long. And it needs a... It needs a tow hitch on the back. I understand that these wheels are a little bit too big for it. But, you know, for lawn art, it won't be too bad until I can whip something else up on the forge. Make them look more realistic. I even painted the spokes with an indelible ink marker. Okay, onto the hitch. Alright, there it is. Now I'm going to give it a quick shot of gray primer and then a shot of black, and my lawn art cannon is finished. There it is in gray primer. As much gray primer as I'm going to shoot at it, because I don't think the rubber on those tires are going to care whether they're primed or not. Nothing's going to stick to them. And there she is. Flat black Yard Art Cannon, ready to get perched out by the garden. Scare away would-be marauders. Anyway, Kevin Bacon, thanks for watching. Bye.